There have been some major announcements recently of some pro teams joining in with Halo Infinite HCS like Envyus, Sentinels, and Cloud9. With all this information happening recently, makes me feel like something's coming around the corner for Halo Infinite's multiplayer. So in this video, we're gonna go into just that. So stay tuned to the whole thing to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another gameplay, commentary, video, news, information kind of stuff today. We're doing some Halo Infinite news as we usually do on this channel, guys. So if you like these news and informational videos, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. It really helps out the YouTube algorithm so more people get a chance to see this video, stay in the know with everything going on with Halo. But guys, something is going on right now with Halo Infinite and its multiplayer side of things. This multiplayer must be looking pretty good for Halo Infinite because there have been some major announcements of some pro teams jumping back onto the Halo bandwagon. With these recent announcements, it makes me feel like something big is about to happen when it comes to Halo. There's still some more things to come when it comes to the multiplayer of Halo Infinite, but I have a feeling we might have some kind of a reveal coming around pretty soon. If you guys remember some of the reporting that we did earlier on this channel, they even thought about dividing up Halo Infinite with different releases, releasing the multiplayer by itself and then releasing the campaign sometime later as kind of a split release to make sure they can have at least have some form of Halo Infinite with the Xbox Series X on launch day. But they decided, no, we gotta combine that all together into one big thing for the guys, because I think that's kind of the right way to do it, because you can't release Halo Infinite just multiplayer or just campaign. It has to be one big thing. There's been some issues with Halo's releases in the last release days of offerings for content and things like that, so they want to make sure they do this one right. But I feel like Halo Infinite's multiplayer is pretty close to being done or ready to go, because there have been some major announcements for teams, guys, and I think we might have some kind of reveal coming. Could you guys check it out right here? Sentinels, you know, formerly known as Tox, formerly known as Optic, the team that's been dominating the HCS side of things when it comes to last 3-4 years kind of thing. They came out and recently announced that they will have the original roster of Tox coming back for Halo Infinite. That means we're gonna have Snakebite, Royal 2, Royal 1, Lethal, and Frosty all coming back for you guys to enjoy and watch these guys just absolutely dominate the field. These guys are the number one team you need to look out for when it comes to the competitive Halo side of things. They recently confirmed their roster on their YouTube channel right here with the announcement of Frosty coming back to Halo, because you know he kind of left for a bit there to try out some things with Call of Duty, and you know he was doing all right there, but you know I think Halo's where it's kind of he's really known for. I mean, he was announced as like what, the greatest player back in 2018 for Halo 5, so definitely goes to show just how talented these guys are, and this is number one team to look out for sure. Another very important team to guys check out is Envyus. They announced their roster. They're coming back to Halo. I think they left the Halo scene right after Halo 5's competitive scene kind of ran up. At least I think the last one I vividly remember was the 2018 finals, and where they had a great team there as well. They announced Pistola, a Pure Gangster, APG, Saiyan, and Trippy. A solid roster to look out for, guys. Envyus is a team that's always been around with Halo quite a long time. They've been out of the loop for the last few years or so, because things have been kind of like up in the air. But seeing Envyus coming back is a big thing. Envyus is actually tied with Call of Duty as well when it comes to their tournaments. So they have some really great ties into the competitive scene when it comes to gaming. And seeing Envyus coming back here is going to be absolutely huge. Having these big names on there is going to be really great to see this competitive list coming in for you guys as well. And on top of this, not only as we get Envyus and Sentinels coming back, but we obviously also now have Cloud9. They recently announced their return back to Halo. They've been away for quite some time. Even during like Halo 5's heyday, they kind of decided to leave the scene there. They're coming back with Eco, Renegade, Penguin, and Stellar, essentially the Splice team that shocked the Halo 5 competitive scene, minus Shotzi, because Shotzi has been killing it in the Call of Duty scene, so I think he's kind of staying over there, replacing him with Penguin. But these guys are fast and furious players and will definitely keep up with anybody out there. They're the team that beat Tox back in the 2018 finals, like, and they changed the game when it came to Halo 5. And so I can imagine the same thing happening with Cloud9's roster right here for Halo Infinite. Keep in mind, actually, Ninja himself was actually a member of Cloud9 back in the day as well, when Halo 5 initially released. So this is a very big name roster coming in for you guys so we can have some more legitimate teams joining in with Halo Infinite's multiplayer side of things. The big thing here, though, so we have these big name teams coming back into Halo, which is fantastic. We do have more announcements to come, but there are some major talents out there waiting to be picked up, needing to be picked up. And I think we might have some more team announcements actually coming in with all these talented players being picked up right now. For all of a sudden, like when the last 2 weeks we've had these major announcements happen, this makes me think that we have some kind of Halo Infinite reveal coming around rather soon, at least within the next few months or so. Maybe like a spring announcement kind of thing to kind of get the hype of the marketing going and stuff like that, to kind of get people jumping in, wanting to play Halo 5 and getting really excited about this. Though this does beg to make me think, though, what other teams will be jumping in? We have some very high name players that want to play Halo 5 competitive that are not actually part of any team particularly. Naming one off the top of my head would have to be Snipedown. Snipedown has mentioned that he wants to be part of Halo Infinite's competitive scene. Right now he's part of Apex Legends competitive scene, which totally makes sense. He recently signed with TSM, one of the largest organizations in competitive gaming, a very prominent name right there. Now, could we see TSM coming in with a Halo roster as well? We never know. If you guys don't know, Snipedown is one of the greatest players in Halo right now, and he's just taking a break, and I guarantee you he can smack probably about 90% of the competition out there. This guy is an absolute legend. I don't know if you guys are familiar with American football at all, but there's a phrase with the Seattle Seahawks of "let Russ cook," meaning just like let Russell Wilson do his thing, control the team, and we'll win the game pretty much. Snipedown is kind of one of those players where you just gotta let Snipedown snipe and he can take over an entire lobby. This guy is an absolute beast, and he's still unsigned when it comes to Halo Infinite for it comes to teams. Will he sign with TSM? Will TSM come out with their own team? Maybe, maybe not. It'd be awesome to see that, help give more legitimacy to Halo Infinite's competitive scene, because it looks like they got some big things coming up for this game, guys. And you know, we have some very prominent ex-pro players right now working on Halo Infinite as part of the pro team over there, you know, finalizing the gameplay, working out the little details to give us the best game we could possibly have. They did the same thing with Halo 5's multiplayer, and I mean, to be honest, Halo 5's multiplayer is one of the best out there, in my personal opinion. I've met the guys who are part of the HCS pro team that are working on Halo Infinite. They're very passionate Halo players that have been around with the game for a long, long time. And so they're definitely a right group of players to get the gameplay just right for Halo Infinite. And to see, hopefully, some other teams jumping in on this guys as well. I mean, I got in talk to some other people within the community as well to talk about, like, are there any other teams might possibly coming out? They go, I can't talk about that right now. Meaning there are going to be some more major teams joining in. Meaning Halo Infinite's multiplayer is something to look forward to. It's going to be something that at least there's going to be some kind of profit in for these teams to jump in and play, guys. Because ultimately, it comes down to prize pool, money earns, and things like that. You know, it takes a lot of time and effort to get these teams to jump into a franchise to be committed. And seeing such large name team organizations like Envy, like Cloud9 jumping back into Halo makes me think that Halo Infinite's multiplayer is the real deal. Especially with these roster lineups that we just see just now, they're quite legitimate. These guys are going to give a strong chance to walk away with some competition here, which is what something we've been really lacking when it comes to HCS side of things. You know, recently the Sentinel teams have been absolutely dominating the Halo competitive scene, and you know, these guys are the, you know, they're the top dogs, and like they're even split up right now between Halo 3 and Halo 5, and they recently both won the online tournaments, which is kind of crazy to think about how talented these guys are. But these recent lineups with Envyus and Cloud9 definitely look to give some solid competition. And with these announcements coming around this time, guys, like we still don't have an official release date of Halo Infinite. There was a leaked art book saying that like maybe sometime in June or something like that. But I think that these announcements would have to come like 6 months before a release or something like that, which would put us into a springtime release. We could possibly see like some multiplayer reveal happening rather soon. Maybe once that multiplayer is officially revealed, we'll see some more teams jumping in and wanting to hop into the Halo scene. I just wanted to bring this up to you guys because there is something a brewing right now when it comes to the Halo competitive scene. Halo multiplayer is something that looks to be hopefully really good, and having all these prominent teams jumping in and making organizations jumping in on the Halo Infinite's bandwagon makes me think that there's something special about Halo Infinite's multiplayer that looks like a really fair, competitive, fun game that people are going to want to jump in and play. Trust me, if these Halo Infinite players saw something funky going on with the multiplayer, they probably wouldn't even bother with it. Or maybe they would if the money's there. We'll have to wait and see, but it just seems like there's a lot of stuff moving in the background here, guys. Obviously, we're all waiting for some more information with Halo Infinite's campaign and multiplayer, but seeing these teams signing up for Halo Infinite this early without even a confirmed release date makes me believe that something maybe like within 6 months or less, maybe within like maybe before the end of the year or something like that, we'll see some Halo Infinite multiplayer reveal happening, showing what we're going to expect for the game. I mean, it sounded like the multiplayer was almost ready to be released by itself back in November, so this makes me think that like the multiplayer is rather complete and ready to roll. But yeah, I think I keep our ears to the ground when it comes to the Halo Infinite multiplayer reveal. I have a feeling we'll see something before the end of this year, so within the next couple months, guys. So definitely we'll be looking forward to that. And if we get that information, I guarantee you I'll make a video on it detailing in high analysis about what to expect for this multiplayer, guys, and what we will see. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I greatly appreciate it. Check out the videos on the screen right over here if you missed any content from me recently. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace out.